Welcome guys to our recorded discussion for the subject Art Appreciation. For this video, here are the objectives or the things that we need to learn. Why do we need to study about arts and humanities? The fundamentals or the principles of arts and humanities? About the nature of arts, arts as viewed by different philosophers, and of course to see the difference between an artist and artisan. Let's start with the definition, guys, on what is art. Ano ba talaga yung art? It's the expression or application of human creative skill and imagination, typically in a visual form such as paintings or sculpture, producing works to be appreciated primarily for their beauty, for emotional power. Imagine this one, guys. Art is more on the beauty and the emotional power of such work. Diba iba talaga yung pag when we see something, we could really consider it as an art if it's something that could provide emotional connection or may connection between the artist and even the viewer, diba? Even from the song, masasabi na, uy, ang ganda naman. Kasi in that way, we really appreciate such art. And it is also the various branches of creative activity, such as painting, music, literature, and dance. Of course, there are many more. Lalo na ngayon that we are living in this highly competitive world, there are lots of things that we could really consider as an art. And the word art, guys, it comes from the Aryan root ar, which means to join or put together. The Latin term source artis mean everything that is artificially made or composed by man. For this subject, guys, we'll be focusing on the art that is artificially made or composed by man. But of course, there are lots of definitions naman when we say art, diba? Even those artists, di naman pwedeng ang art ay artificially made lang by man. Other people would consider something as an art kung made talaga siya ni God, diba? Of course. Kasi there's always beauty in it. And later on naman, guys, papakita ko yung different definition ng art. So, I hope that after this discussion, meron din kasi akong activity or papasagutan sa inyo na question that would provide you an opportunity para i-describe yung art. Kung ano ba talaga siya para sa inyo. Is it more on something that would express your soul? It could be something na na-appreciate mong art. Or art for me is about someone appreciating me sa mga ginagawa ko. Or art could be something na, ano, yung alam mo na nag-effort ka in doing such a thing, diba? I have here, guys, the question, what is art? It has been asked by philosophers, of course, the different answers and perspective about it. Even yung mga authors, musicians, visual artists of all media. Kasi iba-iba naman, lalo na pag iba-ibang forms of art naman yung tinutukoy, diba? And then the discussion has been sometimes analytical, totoo yan, sometimes passionate, sometimes humorous. So depending nga naman talaga sa point of view ng tao. If that person is more on analytical, kung para sa yung art yung ginagawa mo to critique someone's work, to judge or to see the different technicalities, or kung ikaw ba ay more on passionate, kung makikita mo yung effort dun sa art, kung gaano katagal ginawa ng artist, kung paano yung process, diba? And then humorous, minsan you are more into comedy or somewhat like yung mga entertainment na forms of art. And here are the samples of different artists, guys, na sikat talaga kung ano sa kanila yung art. Let's start with Leonardo da Vinci na description kung ano ba talaga yung art para sa kanya. It is the queen of all sciences, communicating knowledge to all the generations of the world. Wow. Yun talaga siya. And diba, makikita naman talaga sa work niya until now, kahit matagal na siyang patay, but until now, diba, yung art na ginawa niya is communicated in different generations of the world. Naging part na nga siya ng subject na pinag-aaralan natin. Kasi yun yung perspective niya about art eh. something na maganda naman talaga pag yung art mo ay it could not be considered only as for this generation only or ngayon lang yung time na to kasi sikat yung form ng art na to, but yung sa kanya talaga. Kaya maganda yung nagiging product, mga paintings niya, sobrang sikat kasi yung mindset niya, perspective niya, gusto niya yung form of art niya could really affect different types of generations. Yung mga ka, anong tawag niya ito? Mga kasabay yung iba't ibang generation, di ba? And we have Michelangelo then. Para sa kanya, the true work of art is but a shadow of the divine perfection. Yes, I do love Michelangelo din. Kasi yung mga forms in terms sa mga gawa niya talaga, di ba? Sa Sistine Chapel or yung andun sa, ano talaga, sa Rome, Italy, yung normally na mga works niya, di ba? It's more on divine perfection. So, yun sa kanya is more on spirituality. Totoo naman talaga yun eh. Bali, pag this type of artist talaga, guys, yung would really, alam mo yun, they don't really own their work. They're so humble enough that yung talent na meron sa kanila is coming from God. And that type of work talaga, when you consider it from coming from God, is napaka-limitless. Kasi, hindi sila, di ba? We all know that human beings have their own limitations. So, ganun. Kaya pala ganun siya kagaling talaga, si Michelangelo. And then, meron din si El Greco, yung para sa kanya, di ba? Isa din siyang sikat na artist. Art is everywhere. You look for it. Heal the twinkling stars, for they are God's careless platters. Diba kanina yung una description based sa book or sa reference talaga, guys? Yung art talaga is most of the time ay sa created by artificially made by man. But of course, sabi ko nga, may kanya-kanya tayong perspective. Mamaya or after ng discussion ko, malalaman ko kung ano ba talaga para sa inyo ang isang art. And I want to see a great description coming from you and make sure you are being yourself, guys, para makilala ko, ah, ganun pala para sa kanya yung art. So ito, si El Greco, ayan, di ba, hindi artificially made by man, but yung sa kanya is more on God's careless platters than yung mga creation ni Lord. And another one from Wolfgang naman, which is based naman siya sa music, art is a mediator of the unspeakable. Galing, no? Short but, ano, terrible or a great, ano, quotation, description about art. So, gusto ko din makita to sa mga paano nyo i-describe yung art, guys. Diba? Mediator of the unspeakable. Kasi sometimes we could not really say or express what we feel through words, but through a form of art, makikita talaga. Or we can speak the unspeakable, diba? Minsan nga, kahit, for example, for me, as a writer myself, minsan pag nagsusulat ako, yun, there are things that are really unspeakable na na-express ko. And then, I later find out kung nagbabasa ako, ay, oo nga, ganun pa rin thinking ko. And sometimes, writing is a hobby that could really help you out naman talaga to organize your mind and or even think for a solution. And then, we have another description naman from Nietzsche. Art is essentially it's essentially the affirmation, the blessing, and the defecation of existence. Galing. Yan, ito yung essential, the affirmation. Kasi once you see something, diba, example nito ay sa mga spoken poetry. It's something like affirmation, diba? It's a blessing that you could express what you really wanted to say. And we have kay Paul, art is a mad search for individualism. Totoo yan. Kasi minsan, through art, we could express ourselves and we could really see, ay, ganun pala siya. Parang it's an individualism. Kasi, diba, like for example, yung isa sa mga sikat na painter, si, meron silang kanya-kanyang strategy or technique that you could say, ah, siya yung nag-ano na, siya yung nag-paint yan. Like, si Van Gogh yung nag-create ng art na yan kasi ganito yung style niya eh. Diba, meron siyang individualism talaga na mas nakikilala siya. And art is a line around your thoughts. Kasi, it's more on your thoughts. Kaya sabi nila, ay one of the great directors talaga na kilala ko ay, ano, yung para sa kanya yung art is more on a great artist is more on copying others' work. Hindi naman siya copy na sinasabi mo lahat talaga kopyahin. But for them kasi, for you to become a great artist, you have to get the thoughts of the different artists tapos ipagsama-sama mo, diba? Kasi sabi na there's no such thing as original in this world, lalo na sa world of art. You can learn from other artists and then you can create your own. And art is the signature of civilization. That's according to Jean. We have Morris then. Art is when things appear rounded, of course, since it's circular, something na nagsishare-share lang talaga or paikot-ikot lang yung idea. Art isn't everything. It's just about everything. Wow. So, ibig sabihin lahat na nakikita niya, even yung napapanood na experience is about really art, be it a negative or positive type of experiences. And kay James Joyce, art is the human disposition of sensible or intelligible matter for an aesthetic end. So, aesthetic, it's more on beauty talaga, about intelligible matter. And Marcel Duchamp, art has absolutely no existence as veracity, as truth. So, napaka-wide talaga ng art. And art seems to be a state of soul more than anything else. Totoo yan. I would agree with this description that it's more on the state of soul. Kasi, di ba, minsan, when you see an art, para sa iba, wala lang, simple lang. But for a person that really appreciate it the most or nakaramdam talaga na, oh, somewhat like, di ba, parang destiny lang, di ba, soulmate, you could really feel something. So, same as an art. You could really, it's also a state of soul that once you feel something for it, na parang familiar siya or it's part of something in me na naintindihan ko yung art na to, yung ganun. Sometimes then, it normally happens na iba yung perception ng gumawa ng artist, tapos iba din yung nakikita ng isang viewer. Kasi, of course, beauty is always in the eye of the beholder, kung sino man yung nakakakita. And art is T.S. Eliot, guys, one of the great writer then. Art is the escape from personality. Totoo yan. Kasi once you see Eliot kasi more of in writing, di ba? Kaya ito yung description niya, escape from personality. Because once you're a writer talaga, you could be everything you want. Yung mga characters nila, parang sinasabuhay din nila yon. Sometimes kasi when you're writing, even if you are that introvert enough, but once you really create a character na confident, extrovert, na kaya makipag-socialize, di ba? Yung they could really create a personality based on their characters na sinasulat nila. O, di ba? Kung mapapansin nyo guys, paano nila i-describe, ay makikita talaga dun sa pagkatao nila on what art is. Kaya sana yun din yung makikita ko sa definition yun ng art. And I want it to be on your own. Huwag tayong mag-copy or gumaya dun sa iba. Here are the functions of art, guys. Kaya kailangan talaga natin itong pag-aralan. And we have to understand it. Kasi, of course, the first function is a human need for expression. Of course, we're built in the human side. Di ba? Halos lahat tayo ay gusto mag-express ng feelings, ng emotions natin. Paano na lang kaya pala pag hindi tayo makapag-express ng ano natin, di ba? Ng feelings or mga thoughts natin. We don't have the freedom. So, ano na lang? Magiging parang robot na lang yung isang tao, di ba? And this needs to express, guys, to show, to exhibit what is hidden in man's inner world. And his thoughts, emotions, imaginations, dreams, and aspirations are expressed in his art. We could not really create something that's not connected to us, or diba? Kaya diba yung ibang description talaga ng art is based on the passion of the artist or yung kagustuhan talaga niyang gumawa. And I have here an example, guys. I do love giving this ano, person or this artist, si Vincent Van Gogh, as one of the, ano, in terms of expressing through his arts talaga. As you can see, itong painting sa baba is, ito yung pinakasikat na painting na ginawa niya, Starry Night. It's actually provided, best may kanta nga na ano eh, based din talaga dun sa painting na to. And Vincent van Gogh, guys, is one of the most famous and influential artists of all time. But let's all remember, guys, that he even struggled in obscurity during his brief life. So, dami din yung struggles na pinagdaanan sa buhay. Imagine that one, guys, if you are very familiar with him, sobrang dami niyang paintings, starting from landscapes, portraits, sketches, and then makikita mo din based dun sa mga ginawa niya kasi gumagamit siya ng vibrant colors, diba? Itong painting na to, yung Starry Night. And then, subjective perspective would revolutionize how the world viewed art. So, pag may pansin mo, di ba hindi naman ganyan dati yung art? Most of the time, it's more on landscape or meron talaga siyang kinokopya. But for him, it's more an expression talaga. Express niya kung naman meron sa imaginations niya or sa emotion niya. Others say that nagawa din na itong painting na to kasi yun daw yung nakikita niya. That's caused by depression or yung mga sa mental health daw niya. But let's find it out, diba? And then, in terms of expression din, guys, alam niyo ba that in less than 10 years na nagpipaint talaga to si Vincent van Gogh talaga, he painted almost 900 paintings. Imagine that one, sobrang dami nun, diba? Every month ata, meron siyang painting every week or even, sobrang dami, 900, hindi yan basta-basta painting lang. And of course, napaka magastos talaga kasi before, mahal din talaga yung mga materials na ginagamit. And it's not just that, at the age of 27, guys, nung nag-27 na siya, he abandoned his unsuccessful career. Unsuccessful talaga siya doon sa pagiging art dealer na, pagiging missionary. So, kaya after noon, nag-focus na siya sa paintings niya tsaka drawing niya. Sometimes it really happened in life, diba? Kaya nga, pag-artist talaga, they're having the hard time or nagkakaroon sila ng dilema kung saan ba talaga ako, am I going to focus on my job, on my career? Kasi nga, sa practicality, di ba? Kailangan natin ng pera. But of course, they also have this kind of thinking. Of course, dapat mas magiging masaya ako eh pag once I'm doing something that I really love, kung saan man ako na art, if I be focusing on sa photography, kasi mag-a-apply na lang naman ako ng sa corporate world, yung mga ganong type of thinking talaga, mahirap. Kaya yung kay Van Gogh talaga, nung dumating yung, nung naging 27 years old na siya, he really focused dun sa painting niya. And he began to paint yung mga farmers as models and even flowers. So, gusto yung mga sunflower, yung mga colorful landscape. And even himself because he was too poor to pay his subjects. Kasi dati pag nagpipili ka talaga ng ng model mo, nagbabayad ka rin talaga. So, kaya sa kanya, galing din siya, no? Kasi yun yung pa yung reason niya. It's to, he's actually poor to pay his subjects. Imagine that one, guys, mahirap na siya. Kaya meron, sabi nga nila, there were researches that was made na kaya daw nagkaroon siya ng mental health problem kasi imbis yung mga pagkain, yung pera niya pambili ng pagkain, binibili daw niya ng mga materials niya. Kaya imagine that one, sobrang dami niyang naipaint, 900 paintings. And yun, yun yung nangyari sa kanya after choosing yung world of art talaga niya. And ito pa, guys, isa sa pinaka mabigat na nangyari sa buhay niya talaga is only one painting sold during his lifetime. Sa dami nang maipaint niya, 'di ba? Bakit isa lang? Pero tingnan niyo naman ngayon, 'di ba? Van Gogh became the famous painter and then kahit nag-struggle man siya because of poverty before and we don't really know, guys, na kayo pala yung next or tayo yung magiging next na Van Gogh in the end. And sa ngayon, guys, yung alam niyo ba na mura lang yung painting na naibenta niya, yung only one painting na nabuhay siya na nabenta. But now, the most expensive painting, guys, cost 148.6 million in 1990. Tapos ngayon, pataas ng pataas na yung prices ng painting niya. Diba ganun ba talaga? Kung kailan namamatay na yung artist, tsaka lang talaga siya nakikilala. And I have here, guys, ito pala yung pinaka-famous na painting niya. A portrait of Dr. Gachet. I could really say, it's still connected dito sa sinasabi na the human need for expression. Kasi yung pinaint niya na to, guys, na si Dr. Gachet, was one of the, ano, yung favorite persons niya in life. But then, so itong painting na to, ito yung talaga yung pinaka-first na version in the year 1890. Then its medium na ginamit niya is all on canvas. Ngayon, ang location niya, it became a private collection. So, we don't really know kung nasaan na or tawag niya, hindi talaga siya pinapakita in public. Nasa private collection siya. And sino ba yung Dr. Gachet na yan? At first talaga, akala ko, sino ba yung ano to? Yung doctor na to? Bakit sobrang halaga ng artist? Kasi, di ba, ikaw ba naman? I really appreciate this at one, guys, na pag isang artist who decided you to be the model or ikaw yung pinipaint niya or dinodrawing, I really appreciate it. Kasi they provided time and effort for it. Hindi yung ano, yung basta-basta, pangit-pangit mo. Dami-dami pang sinabi ikaw nung ginawaan, diba? So that's how art works, guys. Pag yung artist talaga use you as model sa art, you have to be very thankful for it. So, itong lalaking to, guys, or itong doctor na to, during late 1888 kasi, ito si Van Gogh, yung artist, experienced mental breakdown. Kaya nga, nag-cut siya ng part sa ear niya. Diba dito sa painting na to, sa una? Yan. Wala na yung isang tenga niyan o part ng lobes niya, ay ng lobe ng ear. Hindi naman talaga buong ear yung ano. Pinutol, a part of it lang. And he stayed in hospital for a month but was not fully healed kasi dahil dun sa infection din na nangyari. Sabi nga dito, ang naka-assign talaga na doctor niya is ito, si Dr. Gachet. Ayan. At first talaga, negative yung impression niya kay, ano, kay Dr. Gachet. At sabi nga ni, ano, nag-send nga ng message si Van Gogh sa kapatid niya. Sabi niya na, I think that we must not count for Dr. Gachet at all. First of all, he is sicker than I am, I think, or shall we say, just as much. So, that's that. Now, when one blind man, kasi sabi nga niya, di naman nakakatulong sa akin itong ano, yung doktor na to. Paano naman matutulungan nito? Kasi sabi niya, totoo naman that when blind man leads another blind man, don't they both fall into the ditch, diba? Kung pareho kayong, ano, imbis nagpapaguide ka dun sa taong hindi naman din guided or blind din naman. So, pareho kayong mahuhulog, diba? However, guys, after 2 days later, after niya makilala si Dr. Gachet, nag-iba yung perception niya. I have found a true friend in Dr. Gachet, something like another brother. So much do we resemble each other physically and mentally. Kaya imagine this one, di ba, nagawa niyang i-paint si Dr. Gachet. Kaya pag ano ka talaga, pag if you would be closer to an artist, guys, napaka-blessed mo. Kasi you might be remembered as one of the inspiration or even ano, kung kayo ba naman drawing, di ba, tapos napaka-meaningful mong tao talaga, you will still be remembered by a lot of people. Kaya ganun din ka, ano, pag-portrait na paintings talaga. And, talking about him naman, di ba? Kung makikilala mo talaga isang artist, that's how they express. And, painting him, yung doctor na to, is way of expressing talaga ng, ano, ng emotion ng isang artist. Imagine this one, guys, ha? Nung buhay pa nga si Van Gogh, wala masyadong nakakilala sa kanya, but after nung mamatay siya, di ba? Sobrang dami. Even yung mga paintings niya ay nakilala kahit yung mga tao na i-paint niya. Naging part na din na history. And let's remember this one, guys. So I actually got this from, based on the researches nga naman about art. I got this from Britannica.com. Yung philosophy ng art talaga. That the point of this theory seems to be that artists having been perturbed the inarticulateness of their ideas now feel relieved because they have expressed what they wanted to express. Pero meron din silang mga debate about it, kung art is really about expressing someone. Kasi kung makapag-express nga naman sila, bakit nakakreate pa rin sila ng art? Or is it more on expressing or way of relaxing? Bakit laging ganun? Na, is it really more about expressing what they wanted? Diba? Kasi even those artists guys na ano, halimbawa si Moira nga, diba? Yung iba sinasabi na, ano ba yan, nagsusulat pa yun ng sad song si Moira, eh, may asawa na nga siya, or ano, alam mo yung parang may pinagdadaanan daw si Moira. However, ang art, ang nagsulat talaga din is yung asawa niya. But then, yun yung sinasabi, it's not always about expressing what we really wanted to say. Sometimes yung art ay nagiging just because yun yung uso or yun yung alam natin na pupukaw ng mga viewers, diba? Kaya nagbabago na din talaga yung perception natin about art. Pero ito yung isa sa ano guys, it's about expressing oneself. And then, of course, another function ng art is to social need for displaying, celebration, and communication. In this way, that other may know, may empathize, and may realize that people are interconnected. It is not enough for man to express his inner world through his art. He needs to share and convey it to others too. Yan sabi nga, diba, kung yung may mga art kang ginawa, maganda yung you have to share with other people. Even if it's a writing or para sa hindi naman maganda. Because sometimes, other people would really appreciate it para makikita na, ayun nga, ano, napaka-confident naman niya kasi nakagawa siya ng ganung video or na-share niya ganung thoughts na hindi kaya i-share ng iba. Tapos, yun, magkakaroon ng confidence yung iba na dapat pala ganito. Another example, guys, is yung sinasabi, diba, sa social media ngayon na pag mataba ka or you don't have to be ashamed of it, you have to be proud of it. Kaya yung iba nagsuswimsuit or they're sharing pictures na yung mga fats nila, alam mo yung mga insecurities ng girls. There would be positive things, really, dun sa mga nakakakita na ganun din na mataba rin and they don't have really confident sa katawan nila, diba? Seeing that type of art talaga would really boost their confidence din para mabawasan din yung mga insecurities. And I have here another example, guys, is from Anne Frank. I know you're very, most of you are familiar with her and I do love this girl talaga, guys. He wrote The Diary of a Young Girl. So, sino ba to si Anne Frank na yan? So, Anne Frank talaga ay napakagaling, guys. I even read her book a couple of times. So, ito yung masasabi ko na bata pa siya. Kahit 13 years old pa yan siya. Yung thinking niya talaga ay napaka, ano, alam mo yun, parang old soul. Sobrang dami niyang na-share at di mo akalain na naiisip mo pala ng ganong 13-year-old girl pala yan. Actually, si Anne was given a diary talaga on her 13th birthday. And it was something she really wanted kasi yun yung focus niya talaga na art. It's more on writing. Tungkol saan ba yung diary niya? It's also known as Diary of Anne Frank talaga. She was a Jewish teenager who has chronicled her family's 2 years in hiding during the German occupation during sa Netherlands sila during the World War II nung kapanahunan pa ni Hitler, 'di ba? Alam naman natin yung siguro sa history kung gano'ng kahirap yung pinagdadaanan ng mga tao before. Pero kay Anne Frank, way of expressing her feelings talaga yung mga takot niya, sinusulat niya dun sa diary niya. And yung diary niya was 2 years after talaga, naging part na siya ng war literature or na-publish siya. Kahit sinabi natin na, di ba sabi kasi ng iba, it's a diary eh, dapat it's somewhat like public. But based dun sa parents niya, nakitaan nila ng potential talaga na yung diary niya could be a source of inspiration by other people and they have the right to learn talaga kung ano yung pinaka nangyari during World War II, kung ano man talaga yung mga paghihirap na naganap nila. Kaya diba sabi nila, it's displaying talaga an way of communicating or to convey yung message na dapat maiparating natin dun sa ibang tao. And imagine that one, even nowadays, we could learn a lot from her diary eh, based on sa mga nangyari before. And ano ba yung laman ng diary niya, guys? If you will read it, but I would really recommend that you will read the book. Kasi yung content din is about yung sa friend niya, addressing many of the entries. Yung sulat niya kasi, Dear Kitty. And then yung sa unrecounted also day-to-day life within the annex. Kasi nagtago nga naman sila, dapat di sila mahuli ng nung World War II na yon. And the close quarters, yung mga supplies that led to various arguments among the inhabitants. Ikaw ba naman, diba? Parang kung nakakulong kayo ng sobrang tagal, imagine that one, for 2 years. Syempre, nagkakaubusan talaga yung pagkain and they are hiding, bakit silang basa-basang lumalabas lang. And doon makikita mo kung may mga jealousy about adolescent problems, yun yung content talaga niya. And Anne also penned several short stories and compiled at least a beautiful sentences from other works. So, I have here, guys, na example ng ginawa niya for you to see that how come na yung 13 years old na bata ay nakakapag-isip na ito. But of course, kaya for 2 years naman to, so mga 14 na siya or 15, ganun. According to her talaga, I must uphold my ideals for perhaps the time will come when I shall be able to carry them out. So, ayun, di ba yung mga ideals na in life, but imagine that one. She really came it out by yung parent niya to share kung ano may mga content ng diary niya. And lots of people even learned from it a lot. Tapos siya yung nagpauso, guys, or nag-say that dead people will receive lots of flower than those who are still alive, diba? Totoo naman. Kung kailan namatay na yung tao, tsaka na siya nakaka-receive ng lots of flowers, or ibig sabihin, nakaka-receive ng lots of appreciation. Imagine na to, si Van Gogh nga, diba? Kung kailan namatay, tsaka siya, sumikat, ba yung tayong mga ibang artist dyan, ba kung kailan tayo mamatay, tsaka lang sisikat, ba? But of course, maybe there's really a great time for us to be known or to be able to share. Pero ngayon, we could really start sharing our work for others. Kasi nga, it's our way of communicating with the other people sa mga message na gusto nating i-share. And another, guys, is the physical need for functional objects. Of course, ito yung sinasabi na wala naman sigurong daong taong gumagawa ng something na hindi nagagamit. Lahat ng bagay na kinikreate has their own functions, diba? But still, meron ding iba na, are you sure there are actually people who are creating something or work of art na wala namang ka-function at all? And sabi nila, all art is man-made. In the effort to make human life better daw, objects are created, which is also classified as arts, and all of technology is art. It is a careful combination of form and function. So, kahit sa pag-design, diba, there's always a reason behind bakit ganyan yung design, kasi ganito gano'n. There's always a logical reason talaga about it. But I have here an example, guys, if you could see. This is a 22-carat gold toilet paper. So, yan. Naisip niyo na ba na gumamit ng 22-carat na gold toilet paper, guys? So, ito yung isa sa mga controversial that's created object na sobrang mahal. This one is 100% daw usable and safe and made proudly in Australia. So, Australia daw to, nagbe-base yung toilet paper na yan. And sabi nga nila yung nag-create nga nito, fancy throwing your money straight down to the toilet. Ito daw yung sasayang ka lang doon ng pera. But then, yung sa Australia naman, yung nag-create nito, sinasabi nila, it means this is the most expensive toilet paper roll in the world. When you have it, it means na mayaman ka or something that you have to be proud of. But of course, diba, depende na yun kung ano man yung nasa isip ng tao or isip nung bibili ng toilet paper na yan. And don't you know, guys, that it's actually cost $1.37 million talaga. So, napakamahal, diba? And then, even if it's usable, pero hindi eh, diba? Ewan ko. But other people might really appreciate that form of art. And now, I have here another function then, guys. This is a function ng art. I'm sorry. That's the last function ng art. Now, let's talk about an artist. So, ano ba talaga yung artist? We have two guys and difference ng artist tsaka artisan. Now, let's start with an artist. It's a person who exhibits exceptional skills in the visual and or performing arts. Ayan, exceptional skills daw. And like other people, artists are more sensitive, very perceptive, and more creative. Totoo yan. Kaya most of the time, mga artist talaga, isa to sa ano, pinakamahirap talaga. Kasi most of them or more of the artists are sensitive. Kaya pag once you really easily reject the work, tapos easily judge, tapos yung pangit-pangit, wala mga appreciation, diba? Remember, ano kaya ang mararamdaman ng artist na yun, diba? Of course, sometimes you could be the reason why you are killing that passion or yung kagustuhan ng artist na yan to develop more, diba? And they have the knack of interpreting ideas into an artistic form using as their medium the words, pigments, clay, stone, musical notes, or any combination that may best represent this message. I have heard guys from different, ayan, ito yung mga top 5 most renowned artists of all time na kahit hanggang ngayon ay nakikilala pa rin natin sila. We have Leonardo da Vinci, di ba? If you could really observe yung Mona Lisa, yung The Last Supper na sobrang ganda. Kaya meron talaga silang exceptional skills that we could really call them as an artist. Dito si Michelangelo, yan. Si Rembrandt, yan. Favorite ko din yung si Rembrandt. Si Van Gogh, lalo na. And even si Picasso because they have their own ano talaga, skills and talents na exceptional talaga. Nawala sa iba. And, but you know what guys, yung sinasabi ng iba, all of us could always be an artist as long as we put all our hearts or being passionate on what we are doing, that will consider you as an artist already. And ito naman sa artisan, they are a person who is in a skilled trade that involves making things by hand. So ito yung more on sa skills talaga ang artisan. He is a craft worker who makes or creates objects of great beauty by just using his hands. And his creations may be functional or decorative like an earthen pot or palayok for cooking or vase for decoration. So, ito naman artisan, they're doing it for the job para kumita talaga sila. Examples of crafts na pwedeng gawin ng artisan guys, we have furniture, sculpture, glass figurines, metalwork, meron ding food items, yun sila. Artisan focus particularly on the technique and mediums of the craft and through experience on their skills enabling them to reach the expressive levels of an artist. Ibig sabihin guys, an artisan could be an artist as long as they will be able to develop their skills at dapat they could reach the expressive levels of an artist. Kasi yung mga artists, they are doing it to express themselves. They're not doing it just for money or para ano. So, yun, nagiging artist talaga sila. Pero if you're just doing it just for the sake of money or para kumita lang, then that's an artisan. Nasa stage ka pala ng artisan. But if you're really into an expressive level talaga, na gusto mo i-express yung sarili mo, to share and communicate the message to others, that really makes you an artist. Here are the following art forms, guys. We have painting and sculpture. So, marami yan. Let's start with painting first. It's the best described as application of pigment to a surface. So, we'll be tackling about this naman, guys, on the later part of our discussion. Say, kanya-kanya tayo ng chapter, but it's just for you to be familiar or have this, perception kung ano yung mga art forms. And we have the sculpture naman, best described as three-dimensional, of course. It creates a solid form using molding, carving, welding, casting, and assembling. Popular medium naman for sculpture are clay, wood, stone, metal, ice, glass, and plastic. Imagine this one, guys. Para sa akin yung mahirap talaga yung sa ice. Kasi diba, you have to, di basa-basa matutunaw yung ginagawa mo sculpture na based sa ice. And then, we have the architecture din, guys, which considered as the most functional in the art forms. Siyempre, pag-architecture talaga, hindi ka lang nag-create ng something na hindi nagagamit, diba? Lalo na if it's based on sa buildings or, alam yung gamit na gamit talaga siya. Kaya, it's the most functional. It involves creating designs for buildings and infrastructures to be functional. It involves using the design to build the structure through the help of engineers, contractors, and skilled workers. So, hindi lang pwedeng basta-basta isa lang na tao ang gumagawa dyan. Of course, it's a group of people talaga in terms of designing, sa mga engineer, diba? So, isa sa mga sikat talaga ng mga lugar, guys. We have Singapore, sa Dubai. Ayan, sobrang gaganda talaga ng mga architecture na yun. Alam mo yung pinagagastusan. Tapos, very creative talaga yung pagkagawa. And we also have music, guys, considered as an art form and even the dance. Music is the art of sound expressed through song, through the use of instrument or combination of both, and should express rhythm, harmony, and melody that is soothing or appeals to the taste of its audience. Pero minsan talaga alam nyo, guys, na kahit yung mga rock music, diba, we don't really appreciate it that much, or hindi sa lahat ng, ano yun, magkanya-kanya tayong audience. Other audience would really love to listen to love songs. Yung iba, more on sa mga instrument lang, or yung iba, they wanted to hear inspirational songs. Of course, may kanya-kanya din silang genre kahit sa music. Kaya, diba, ano, it doesn't mean na ano yung ginagawa natin could always say yes to all the audiences. May kanya-kanyang group talaga that really wanted your art and other might really hate it. Kasi iba kahit gano'ng kaganda yung kanta, diba? Ano ba yan? Kasi sa YouTube, diba, mapansin nyo na ganda-ganda na nga, yung ganda ng lyrics ng video, tas dami-dami pa rin nag-unlike. Sino ba itong mga taong nag-unlike? But of course, we could not really blame them kung para sa kanila, ayaw nila ng ganun type of art. I have here, guys, from Macklemore. Ito naman perception niya as an artist, music artist. Para sa kanya, music is therapy. Music moves people. Totoo yan. It connects people in a way that no other medium can. It pulls heartstrings. It acts as a medicine. Grabe nung ganun pala talaga yung music para sa kanya. Ganun yung artist, guys. Diba? Napaka-exceptional. Tapos napaka-ano nila. They are really connecting their lives. Or parang sinasabuhay na talaga yung kung saan yung art na gusto nila. And in terms sa dance naman, it is a art of body movements that is attuned to a musical piece. Body movements should be graceful and in rhythm with the accompanying musical piece. In ancient times, dance is used as a form of worship kasi yun yung paano nila ma-express yung sarili niya, to express their love, yun yung base ng dance. I have here a quotation naman from, that's coming from a dancer. Kasi di naman ako dancer eh. So I really need this ano, perception as a dancer. I am a dancer. I don't dance because you want to. I dance because I need to. O, diba? They don't really want to, but they need to. Kasi ibig sabihin, parang buhay na nila yung pagiging dancer. I tell a story by the movements of my body. I dance because I get this amazing feeling through the movement of my arms and the rhythm of the music. I dance because it makes me happy. I am an artist, an athlete, and a dreamer. I am a dancer. So yun, diba? Pag dancer ka talaga, you are already an artist, an athlete also, and a dreamer. Kasi mas na-express nga yung pag ano, diba? Yung world of art mo into dancing. Yun. Eh, diba pag ano talaga, sa mga judges, kung dancer talaga sila, they're really an artist. Gusto nilang makita yung ano, yung rhythm, yung movement. Diba, iba yung parang pagsasayaw, tapos napaka-effortless. Tapos parang ang ganda-ganda nila tingnan. Kasi yun yung artist na talaga sila. And web literature naman, it's the art of using words to express thoughts, ideas, and feelings. And this may take the form of poetry, so novels, a short story, essay, epic, and legends too. Mention a few. So, sobrang dami talaga in terms of literature. I know that some of you are really into reading. And ito naman yung sinasabi ng writer, guys. So, being an artist, ano ba talaga para sa kanila yung writing? I am a writer. We are the people who stay up past 12 a.m. finishing a story. Totoo yan. Minsan naabot ng 8 years, 10 years, yung pagsusulat ng story talaga. ganun yung effort talaga. Kasi, yan, we're misunderstood and underpaid. Minsan, kung may sinasabi yung, ano, diba, yung writer, parang di namang, ano yung pagkaintindi ng iba out of context, or parang sinisiraan pa yung writer, tapos underpaid. So, imagine that one, diba? If you're familiar, yung sa, kay Dean nga, diba, nagsusulat siya ng book. Kung sumali kayo sa ano, seminar, sabi nga niya, sa 180 pesos, I think is 5 pesos lang yun as a writer, yung napupunta sa kanila, 20 pesos sa kabuong writers. But yung sulat ng book na yun, apat sila, tigli 5 piso lang meron sa kanila kung may nabentang book, di ba? Imagine that one, napaka-underpaid talaga ng mga writers, guys. And but we bring to life characters, totoo yan, in a world that society never knew about. Maya, ano ka na lang, no? Kung makikita mo sa mga movies, ano, galing, galing naman ang nakaisip na yun. They are actually the writers, so think about it. And, but we, because we remember being like you, wanting to escape from reality. And I am a writer and I love it. Kahit, sabi ko nga, diba, hindi talaga money yung pinag-uusapan dito when you're an artist, guys. But as long as you're really happy in what you're doing, ayun, that would really make you a true artist. But of course, let us not forget, guys, to support artists talaga. Kasi yun na yung ano nila eh, kabuhayan nila, diba? And huwag tayo mag-underpaid ng mga artists kasi dugot pawis yung binibigay nila sa art nila. And theater, guys, it's a performance of drama. Theater may be referred to as combined or performing arts. It may include music, dance, and literature. Actors perform on stage in front of live audiences. And dialogues may be recited, sang, or eliminated. Ayan. Sobrang hirap din kaya ng theater, guys. Example nito ay si, ano, si Lea Salonga. If you're familiar with her, dun sa pinakagusto niyang kwintas is yung elephant, yung symbol. Kasi nga daw, pag sa theater daw kasi, sobrang haba ng memorize mo, na mga lines. Imagine that one, ilang oras yung theater lang na pag mga presentation, diba? Sobrang haba. Tapos paano mo, ibig sabihin pag theater kasi live, diba? Tapos magkamali ka ng memorize mo, diba? Sobrang hirap. Pero kaya nga si Lea Salonga is really good in memorizing. So sabi niya, ang gusto niya talaga yung memory ng elephant kasi napaka-flexible. Tapos sobrang ano, imagine that one, after lots of how many years, naalala pa nila kung anong amoy ng anak nila or ano. Sa ganun ka, galing talaga yung mga elephant. So, same as an artist, guys. Pag sa theater ka, you will have to have lots of, ano, dapat pass yung terms of memorizing. And great theater is about challenging how we think and encouraging us to fantasize about a world we aspire to. So, magpa-fantasize ka. Dapat magaling ka. Hindi lang sa memorize, ha. Even the acting, kung musical theater din yan, dapat maganda yung boses mo, diba? And art form may be classified as visual art and performing art. So, hindi lang talaga siya sa visual, sa pagdodrawing or sa painting. There are also performing arts like the theater, dancing, music, relax. And art is viewed by philosophy, guys. Of course, may kanya-kanya din silang view about this. Aesthetic. It is the philosophical study of beauty and taste. So, once we are going to study the beauty of something, guys, or an art, yun yung tinatawag na aesthetics, okay? It is concerned with the nature of art and used as basis for interpreting and evaluating individual works of art. A set of principles concerned with the nature and appreciation of beauty, especially art. It comes from the Greek word na aesthetikos, relating to perception by the senses, from aestheta, perceptible things, okay? So, yun yung tinatawag na aesthetics. And in order for the arts to be completely understood, views of three famous philosophers are undertaken, guys, from Plato to Aristotle, and lastly, kay Immanuel Kant. Now, let's start with kay Plato naman. A philosopher of ancient Greece, guys. I know you're very familiar with him. Lagi na natin siyang naririnig from high school, or even elementary siguro. Known for his famous dialogues that include his equally famous teacher na si Socrates, considered the arts as threatening. He saw how powerful the arts can be in shaping a person's character. So, ito si Plato, in terms sa art, masyado siyang nega. Diba? Kasi para sa kanya, it's threatening. Pero, totoo din talaga, guys. Kaya diba, pag ikaw naging parent or may mga kapatid kayong bata, you have to be very careful kung ano yung pinapanood nila or pinapakinggan nila kasi nga, it could be threatening kung, kasi it could shape their character eh. Kahit yung mga nilalaro nilang games, if it's very violent talaga, then you have to be mindful of it. Baka maging ganun din sila in the future or paglaki, diba? Kaya properly guided dapat ng mga ano, ng responsible individuals or ng guardian. Ito naman si Plato. Kaya so, art is threatening talaga. There are instances, kahit sa mga ano, diba, nowadays, sa politics, pag may nakikita na there's something an art na sinulat or be it a song na doon pinapakita talaga yung mga corruption or paano nangyayari yung anong ginagawa ng government, diba, sometimes it could really be a threat to other people. Kasi pag, lalo na pag pinapalabas doon, ah, ganun pala siya. But there are actually songs that were made na pag naalala yung kanta, ay, yung kanta yan, based yan sa gantong nangyari kay ganto-ganyan, yung mga tao that I would not really mention. Kasi yun naman ay based sa mga kwento-kwento or haka-haka. Pero yun sinasabi, it could be a threat talaga. Kaya yun si Plato, focus siya sa negative. And ito naman kasi yung two ideas niya, guys. Pero hindi lang naman siya sa negative, ha? Pero din positive. Pero ewan ko ba if it's considered as positive. So para sa kanya, art is imitation. He explained that art is an imitation of physical things, which in turn are imitations of the forms. Art is a copy of a copy, which leads to people further away from the truth. Yan. So si Plato yung isa sa nag-agree that there's no such thing as original in this world. We are just copying it or getting that information from other. Kasi nga, diba, kung naisip mo nga, hindi, or sure na, hindi din naiisip ng ibang tao yun. Of course, naiisip din nila yun. So, nasa ano lang yan, palakasan ng confidence talaga for you to convey the message or share it with the public. And art is dangerous. It's the power to steer emotions, diba? Sometimes, kakapakinig mo nga naman ng mga sad songs, imbis gusto mong maging masaya, maging malungkot ka lang, diba? It's still your choice. If you want to become happy, then listen to happy songs or watching happy movies then. And next is si Aristotle naman, famous philosopher then, student siya ni Plato. So, tingnan natin kung naging ano ba siya, kung napasunod ba siya ni Plato. So, ito naman si Aristotle, guys, distinguish between what is good and what is beautiful. O, diba? Good news, hindi siya ano sumunod sa perception na meron yung professor, yung teacher niya. So, yung sa kanya naman, good and what is beautiful. So, dalawa lang sa kanya, no, from art. It could be a good or a beautiful one. Stated that good always present always in some action or thing, a beauty may exist even in motionless objects or things. Ayan. So, walang negative kay Aristotle, guys. Nasa good lang or beautiful yung art sa kanya. Kasi, ito yung description niya, guys, sa ano, on what art is. Art completes what nature cannot bring to a finish. The artist gives us knowledge of nature's unrealized ends. Ayun, kasi minsan may mga bagay talaga that we don't know the end yet. But through a form of art, yan, magiging, ma-realize natin through the imaginations or thoughts of an artist. Tapos, lastly guys, kay Immanuel Kant naman, iba din naman to siya. Kasi, US a German Enlightenment philosopher. Para sa kanya, yung art talaga is art itself. Was not in art itself, but in beauty. Gusto niya yung pinaka-beauty talaga. Yung pinaka-focus niya. Diba kay Aristotle kasi, good in beauty. Yung sa kanya naman, more in beauty lang talaga. Kasi thought that beauty does not rest on the properties of the object or things, but rather on the manner in which people respond to these objects or things. Beauty is a matter of taste. And kay Immanuel Kant is, beauty is always in the eye of the beholder. So, nasa tao na yun kung anong para sa kanya maganda, di ba? Yun yung pinaka-focus niya. Kung sino, depende sa taste ng viewer or sa mga nakikita. Kung para sa inyo, sa'yo, yun yung maganda. Then, I have to respect it, di ba? Kasi, iba-iba tayo ng taste eh. So, yun yung si Immanuel Kant. So, ang galing din to si Immanuel Kant, yung description niya ng art talaga. Ay, depende kung sino ang nakatingin. Kasi, we have different point of view naman kung anong maganda, di ba? Minsan, paano yung maganda sa akin, pangit sa iba, or they don't really appreciate it at all. And now, let's start with the classification of arts naman, guys. We have 6. Meron tayong fine art, visual, plastic performance, applied, and decorative. Let's start with the fine art. It's a visual expression naman, or application of human creativity involving both the technical know-how, yung skill, and ability to think of a new things. So, it is helpful to note, guys, na yung word na fine does not indicate the quality of the artwork, ha? But rather the purity of the discipline. Ayan. So, ganun pala, no? Pag sa artist talaga, pag fine art, it's not about yung quality na ginawa ng isang artist, but about the purity of the discipline. Kasi once you see something na art, pag sa fine art kasi makikita nyo, o pag nalalaman nyo, grabe ka, disiplinado pala yung gumawa nito, yung artist nito, diba? Ibig sabihin, for them to create this form of art, ano, they really showed effort, dugot pawis din yung inalay nila para paganda yung art na yun. So, that what makes it fine, ha? Let's don't, ano, ialis natin sa isip na pag fine art, fine, ibig sabihin quality, di porket pangit yun sa'yo. Fine art ba ito dapat, diba? Fine art dapat maganda. Okay, di dapat ganun. Fine art dapat should be more on the purity of the discipline, okay? And, this category, guys, includes ng mga drawing. We have painting, printmaking, sculpture, and calligraphy. So, you could just, I know you're familiar with this. Just be, ano, mindful, guys, kung sa drawing, ano yung mga ginagamit na materials, okay? But we'll be discussing more about this naman for the next chapters. And visual art, new media, guys, nowadays, we have the digital art, computer graphics, sa mga IT people dyan. I know that you are into this. Merong internet art, interactive art, video games, guys. So, diba? Kasama talaga siya sa visual art. And 3D printing and art as biotechnology, photography, environmental, and even contemporary forms, guys, ng expression. Like collage or conceptual installations. I have here an example, guys, of a 3D a painting. Diba? Nakikita mo talaga na hindi yan basta-bastang ginagawa lang. It really takes so much time tsaka effort para mas mapaganda yung presentation. Next is the plastic art. The term plastic art includes artworks talaga that are molded and not necessarily plastic objects. This category consists of three-dimensional works like clay, plaster, stone, metals, and wood and paper. So, hindi lang siya more on plastic. So, I have here an example by Vestito Blue. Na art on 2005 that was created with mineral water bottles, na plastic bags, created by Enrica Borge. So, it forms which involve physical manipulation of a plastic medium by molding or modeling such as sculpture or mga ceramics. And next is the performance art. It's traditional performance art, the theater, opera, music, and ballet. So, yeah. Magagaling din talaga pag sa performance art. You should be confident enough. Tapos, dapat sanay ka talaga humarap sa maraming tao din pag sa, pag, with this form of art. So, dapat hindi nasisira naman talaga yung presentation. Lalo na pag mas mahaba yung ano, time na ginugugol niya sa pag-practice, diba? And next is the applied arts. Ano ba yung applied art? This category naman encompasses the application of aesthetic designs to everyday functional objects. Ibig sabihin na apply yung mga different forms of art like includes architecture, computer art, photography, industrial design. The applied arts are the application of design and decoration to everyday objects to make them aesthetically pleasing. Halimbawa, itong building na ito na nasa picture. So, they put designs in it. Yan yung sinasabing applied art. Yung naglalagay tayo ng design or decoration sa mga everyday objects na lagi nating nakikita. And lastly, we have the decorative art, guys. Ito naman, from the word decorative or decoration, this classification refers to functional but ornamental art forms such as jewelry, ceramics, mosaic art, and other items that are embellished by ornaments and other designs. It also includes works in glass, clay, wood, metal, textile, fabric, furniture, furnishing, stained glass, and tapestry art. Diba? Ito yung sa, more on sa mga Japanese people talaga. They do love this type of art, decorative art. But even nowadays, diba, sa mga tao ngayon, they wanted decorations din para sa bahay nila para mas mapaganda at mas maganda sa paningin ng mga tao or even sa ikaw nakatira, diba? That would make you comfortable if you see something beautiful inside your house. So, I have here, guys, the references about the things that we've talked about art. And I hope that you learned something. And I really expect na magaganda yung mga description niyo din on what art is. Okay? So, that's all for today. See you on the next discussion. Thank you.